do's and don'ts with science fiction.
Yeah, I got a few, so I'll try and go through them pretty quickly. Do it, don't say you're gonna do it. Some people will say, I have this great idea, and they want their friends to go, that's a great idea, and then they can ignore ever doing it because they've already got positive feedback, they want to do it. Sometimes you need to go out and learn more about the craft. You might need to get a, you know, take courses in creative writing, you might take courses in comic books. They're saying it's easy. Sometimes it's easy for some people. Sometimes there are things you need to learn and remember, as Joanne said, there aren't rules, but there are some guidelines that can help you. One of them is the 3 points of description, then get to the action and dialogue. That doesn't mean you do 3 for every character or 3 for every scene, but if you're gonna do 10, they better be good points of description. If you're gonna do 1, it better not be that important that you know exactly what that person's like. In terms of character development, don't listen to the people who say fiction and stories is all about characters. They're right to an extent, but it's only one of the factors. If you have the best fleshed out characters ever and nothing interesting goes on, like My Dinner with Andre, you know, and they were great characters, but it bore me to tears because nothing happened. Babylon 5, incredible characters, interesting plots, fascinating ideas all thrown together. If you think it's only about the idea, you're as wrong as you think it's only about the characters. When you get the feedback, listen to the good stuff. You will get some bad stuff, so what? People are all gonna get it. Remember the good stuff, don't let the bad stuff drag you down too much. One person had this long drawn out attack on some of my writing, ending with, he compared it to a mixture of Jerry Lewis and Richard Feynman. And I'm like, 10 years later, I'm like, somebody compared me to Richard Feynman? One, my assistant editor, my wife Stephanie, often says, is if you're sending out a story to a magazine, don't label it as humorous. Don't say, here's my humorous story, because if the reading editor reads it and didn't laugh or didn't find it funny, they're gonna think, okay, it failed, right? Where they might have read the story and go, this is a really interesting story, you know, that somebody may or may not react humorously to without a fail. So just present it to them. If they laugh, great. If they don't,
Although you might want to add, like, you might want to say, this is my humorous story, talking about the bone in your arm.
Yeah.
My 7-year-old would
love that joke.
This one. Yeah, I mean, this one, yeah. My Nazi anatomy.